In this TI DLP Labs video, we will discuss a convenient method and tool for estimating the volume of a HUD system. As head-up displays grow in popularity and market share, size of the displayed image also grows. Moving to augmented reality head-up displays, or AR HUDs, display sizes can exceed 15 degrees field of view, or FOV. While this increased FOV allows displays covering more of the road in front of the driver, it also presents several challenges. One main challenge with AR HUDs is physical volume, with the largest systems approaching 20 liters of space. This can be difficult to fit in many small cars due to interference with the steering column, HVAC systems, and brake pedal. This is a typical layout of an AR HUD. The HUD is located below the car's dashboard and consists primarily of the projector, diffuser, and large freeform mirror. The projector and diffuser screen make up the picture generation unit, or PGU, and form a real image on the diffuser screen. The light from this image is then reflected off the freeform mirror and again off the windshield to be redirected into the driver's eye box. The virtual image is projected at the virtual image distance, or VID, and the size of the image is determined by the horizontal and vertical field of view, or FOV. There are three main steps in the process for estimating the volume requirements of an AR HUD. First, from the FOV, VID, and eyebox requirements, the size of the large mirror must be estimated. Once this is calculated, the size of the diffuser and mirror can be used to find the total volume occupied by the main optical path. Finally, the size of the mechanical components, thermal solution, and layout must be estimated to determine the final volume of the AR HUD system. Taking a closer look at the layout of an AR HUD, we see the projector and diffuser screen create an image which is reflected off the freeform mirror, here labeled M1, to the windshield and eye box. There is a large cavity created between the diffuser screen and mirror which must be left open for the optical path. Overall volume in a HUD system is primarily affected by the size of the large freeform mirror. The larger this mirror is, the larger the optical cavity becomes. The size of this mirror is mainly determined by three HUD system parameters, FOV, eyebox, and to a lesser extent, VID. Increasing FOV or eyebox size will cause a nearly linear increase in overall volume, whereas increasing VID has a more logarithmic relationship. This graph shows the relationship between eyebox size, mirror size, and virtual image distance in the horizontal dimension. We can see that by changing the FOV or eyebox size specifications, the mirror size is significantly changed. But when the VID is reduced from 10 meters to 7.5 meters, the mirror size remains almost unchanged. Increasing or decreasing the FOV shows an almost linear change in overall volume. Smaller FOV and eyebox combinations can have volumes below 8 liters, while AR HUDs with the largest FOV and eyebox specifications can approach 18 liters with traditional optics. Changing VID will have a significant effect on mirror size and overall volume at short VIDs. There is a significant volume increase changing the VID from 2 meters to 6 meters, but very little difference for VIDs greater than 6 meters. To help understand the impact of different parameters on overall volume, TI has created an Excel tool to estimate the necessary required volume of an AR HUD system. This tool can be downloaded by going to the link in the video description. The AR HUD Volume Estimation Calculator uses standard HUD parameters such as FOV, eyebox size, and VID to calculate an estimated overall volume occupied by the HUD system. The included graphs show approximate sizes of vertical and horizontal dimensions of the virtual image formed, allowing the user to estimate what portion of the road may be displayed upon for a given set of parameters. Near the top of the calculator are the input parameters. Included are high-level parameters of the overall HUD design, as well as some system-dependent parameters. Updating these parameters will update the volume estimates in real time. Field of view, virtual image distance, and eyebox size can be updated to understand the relative volume requirements for different HUD designs. Mirror 1 obliquity angle will typically be fixed by the design of the car windshield. HUD diffuser screen image width is calculated automatically based on the FOV and VID requirements above. It is scaled along with the mirror magnification to maintain reasonable design constraints. Mechanical volume increase is an estimated parameter to factor in mechanical housings, mounting features, thermal solutions, and other non-optical features of a HUD system. 30% is a typical value for some designs, but may be adjusted for individual designs. This calculator estimates volume for a one-mirror system. If designing with multiple mirrors, increasing the M1-M2 overlap fraction can account for the portion of the optical path occupying the same volume. The calculator output section shows estimated values for mirror dimensions, virtual image size, magnification, and volume estimates. All calculator outputs are calculated in real time when inputs are updated. There are two volume estimates included. The first is the estimated volume of only the optical components. The total mechanical volume estimation includes the increased volume from the mechanical components included in the input section. Inputting moderate HUD specifications to create a medium-sized AR HUD image and using FOV of 10 by 3, a VID of 7.5 meters, an iBox size of 140 millimeters by 60 millimeters, and the other default parameters, we see a total estimated required volume of 6.9 liters. Inputting HUD specifications to create a much larger AR HUD image and using FOV of 15 by 5, a VID of 15 meters, an iBox size of 140 millimeters by 120 millimeters, and the other default parameters, we see a total estimated required volume of 19 liters. Total volume is not the only consideration when fitting an AR HUD system into a vehicle. There are often other systems using the same space under the dashboard that the HUD needs to fit next to. Some of these systems include the steering column, brake pedal, HVAC ducts, and the car frame. Because most of these components limit the vertical space available, height is often the limiting constraint, not just total volume. Vertical FOV and iBox height have the greatest impact on overall HUD height and can often be traded off for a smaller volume system. Total volume of an AR HUD should be considered early in the automotive design process. Space should be allocated when designing the car frame and dashboard to minimize design challenges later in the process. For more information on this topic, please see the other resources on ti.com/DLPAuto. Thanks for watching.